Yeah. Have you enjoyed it so far?
It's been brilliant. Yeah, I love it all. I come to all the events, all the replay events, and it's just brilliant every time. Yeah.
So have you had any go on all the machines, all the arcade machines and everything like that, or have you not had time?
I don't have to. I've had one game.
What was that then?
That was Point Blank. Yeah, I was just giving it a try because I went to the arcade club. I went there to pick up Metrex because I'm doing Longjack and Metrex. And so I went to pick up the Metrex from the guy who's lending me his Metrex. And we met there and we were having a couple of games. So we said, yeah, we had a, he challenged me to a game on Point Blank.
Yeah.
And I wiped the floor with him. And he's like, right, when we come to play, replay Blackpool, I want to have another rematch. Yeah. So, unfortunately, I haven't seen him yet. So,
we're not taking half an hour to like walk around. So, okay, so what was the very first game that you ever played?
Space Invaders. It is highly up there. I'd have to say Scramble. Yeah. It's a strange one, yeah. Basically, we had a Spark shop, you know, the convenience store local to us, and we had a sit down version of Scramble at the back of the shop.
Yeah.
And what they did was they had a competition where the first person to complete the Scramble won a tenner.
Oh, okay.
And won a tenner! Like, yay! I probably spent more than 10 quid practicing, but yeah.
If you could take two games you have made, Miami to one, what would it be? Why?
Is that the question?
Yeah, that is the one.
Oh, that is a good one.
You have to pattern this as well, because you're probably going to end up making it.
Yeah. I'd like to do a Midnight Resistance 2, but what I would put with it out of the games I've written, and I hope it might have to be Cabal, maybe some kind of Cabal or hype thing, some Midnight Resistance maybe. I could probably work, maybe. Who knows?
Yeah, it might work.
Yeah. Or maybe it could be like cut scenes, like you go side on for one and then into the screen for the other.
Striker.
Yes. I did actually, because you have more choice over when you actually see when you're playing. I mean, I know you're too busy concentrating on the player to then have to look after the goalie as well.
Yeah.
But I like the idea where you can control where you want to position.
Yeah.
Like, say this was the goal.
Yeah.
Like, you don't always want the goalie where. So, it's like, you want to be here, so you need to have more control. I haven't done PS4 yet. I'm working on a PS4 app at the moment in VR. VTime, it's a social network app, It's out on Gear VR at the moment. I can show you a demo if you want. Basically, it's a social networking app. You put your headset on. Talk to people around the world, you have four people in the room, go to the first
place. Like
say we're here, be here, you there, and then someone here, and you go to different destinations like Paris, the Arctic, go to the ISS space station, go under like 400 metres under the sea. I'll show you. And when you think that the version I've got, I'm going to be showing it, is running on a phone. And like, they've got like the high-end PCs running the Oculus. And then you see this on the phone. And like, how the hell is this working on a phone?
That's only blowing my mind right now. Yeah. I mean, like, so that's going
to
be on PSVR.
Yeah, it's going to be on PSVR. Yeah. It's going to be on HTC Vive. It's going to be on Oculus Rift.
Yeah.
It's going to be on Cardboard. And it's going to be on Gear VR.
And it's going to be VR.
Ooh. I know. Well, the thing is, I don't want to, like, I want to say, but I don't want to say, because I don't want to, if I say something.
Say, like,
no, I'm not saying anything negative about them. They've all got their own strengths. Like, I like the fact that with the five, we've got the finger control, no, the hand controls. So, like, the archery game, like, there's a demo called The Lab, and if you play on it, it's
good.
That would be absolutely fantastic. That would, yeah, I mean, if Zuckerberg wants to buy them out, then probably, he's got the pennies, so you never know. Yeah, if we get the next Facebook, who knows? But yeah, it'd be nice to have that kind of backing behind us. We've got a brilliant community of followers, of the users that are actually using the app. And what's nice about it is they're not going in and beefing people. It's a really friendly community, which is every, like, every social media is doing this thing, yeah? So, can't ask for a better, like, set of users, yeah? So, it's all good. Yeah, I know. But, I mean, the thing is, there will be a point when you do, but we've got the point where you can block people if someone's been blocked them, so you'll never see them again. You can report them so they can get their accounts. If enough people report them, they'll get their accounts, because we're having a zero tolerance on people being households, because we don't want, like, people to be going on for it. Yeah, we want to be friendly, yeah. Don't want to be going on and getting grief, and you just want to go and talk to your friends and whatever. So, yeah.
Thank you for doing the interview.
Yeah, it's been a pleasure.
Appreciate it.
Yeah, thanks.